everyone, this is Mrudhula Basker and welcome back to my channel. So today I have a video where I'm going to reveal how I have arranged all my jewellery. I wouldn't particularly be showing you all the jewellery collections that I have because there are so many and there wouldn't be enough time in one video to show it to all of you. So I'll put up other videos in the future to show what are the kinds of jewelry that I have. This is going to be a video which shows how I organize my jewelry, where I have placed it, so that you can just take little ideas from here and there to keep your space organized. Mr. YouTube says that most of you watching my videos are not yet subscribed to my channel. So please hit the subscribe button. It'll do a whole lot of good to me. Without wasting any time, let's jump right into the video. So this happens to be the cupboard in which I place all my jewelry. So there are two drawers over here. There is a full cupboard. This is supposed to be my dressing table, but it is just remade into where I keep my jewelry. Once I open that up, I'm going from the bottommost. So these are my earrings kept in stands. These are my daily essentials that I would require before I just step out, or you know, before I go to bed, or you know, as soon as I wake up in the morning. So these are some of the boxes that I have with some of my jewelry kept there, and these are also more of my jewelry, and that's my hair curler. Let's go from the bottom of the shelf. So first I have some of my jewelry hung over here. I've used two of these, you know, jewelry display units because I have a store. I sort of bought it for the store. I ended up buying them for my house as well. So these are some of my jewelry. This is twistable, so you can just twist it and everything is sort of placed and arranged. All my white metals are put together so that it's easy to find whenever I require it. And this is again a shelf in which a lot of my jewelry are kept. So these are the jewelry which I would normally use when I'm stepping out, when I need to take out urgently, where I don't plan beforehand as to what I'm gonna wear. So these are the jewelry I'll usually go for. So yeah, these are my earrings. So next up here in this shelf, I have my face wash, hand cream. I have a night cream over here, my toner and some cotton, and you know, some pain relief sprays, perfumes, my face brush and all that. So these are some miscellaneous stuff. Some of my tablets are also kept there. So there you go. And next up we'll go to this box over here. So I'm moving on to the first thing which was kept over there. So let's have a look at what is there. So these are some of my colorful studs which I like a lot. I bought it as a whole piece. So these are the colorful studs which I'm very fond of. There are some floral studs which, you know, look like this. So these are very cute. Just some miscellaneous stuff. A ring which I've just thrown in sometime after wearing it. So that is it. And this is a terracotta set, a very pretty terracotta set. And this is also terracotta. Most of this box has my terracotta and metallic western wear stuff. These are, you know, 5 or 6 necklaces just thrown in. You know, these are, you know, I seldom use it, so it's just kept over there. And again, this is another terracotta set, which is a very beautiful one. It's got a very, very pretty jhumka. See? Yeah. So, and this part has some of my jute jewelry. This is a jute earring, and this is a jute set that I have. So that's it. So this is the box which was kept over here. So in this I have, you know, some of my necklace sets, one with pearls, and you know, mostly all the earrings will be kept here because both these earrings would look similar, and you know, I would just match my outfit to the earring that I wear. So most of the earrings will be put in this, and the neck pieces will be put in this. So this is again a very, very beautiful neck piece with a Lakshmi on it. So this I wear with silk saris or sometimes even with costumes. And this is a Saraswati themed necklace which I picked up. So this is actually a silver necklace. This is got the Navaratan stones on it. So it's got a earring as well. I put it in a plastic bag because silver tends to get dark very fast if you put it in cloth. This is another white metal neck piece. It's a beautiful neck piece, like you all can see.
So it's got a peacock theme on it. And this is a beautiful necklace again. It was gifted by my dance teacher to me when my first movie released. So it's a very, very memorable one. I really love this necklace. Such a beautiful one. So very fond memories with these neck pieces. So we're done with this box. We will move on to this box now, and there's a box above that. So first let me go ahead and show you that. This box has some miscellaneous terracotta things. I was on a spree of making terracotta jewelry. So I ended up making some terracotta. I'm not a professional or anything, but yeah, just out of passion. So these are all jhumkas, and this is a set which I made. So some random stuff lying in there. This is a small stud that I had made. So yeah, so this is also another terracotta earring. So these are some of my favorite terracotta pieces that I made. So just for memory, it's not, you know, very beautiful or good looking that I can wear it every now and then, but just for memory. So moving on to this box. So this is again some of the jewelry which is my favorite, some oxidized silver. This is a ghungru. This is a necklace with a ghungru on it. I actually designed it myself, and it's one of my favorite pieces because I'm a Bharatnatyam dancer, and you know, these things are very close to my heart. And I have a couple of other necklaces over here, all, you know, chokers and all oxidized silver jewelry. So that's there in this drawer. Next up in this, I have some gheru and dokra jewelry. So this is a Ganesha themed gheru bead jewelry. This was very famous at one point in time. In case you all want to see like a detailed video of what are the different kinds of neck pieces I have, I'm more than happy. I'll be more than happy to show it to all of you. So this is also a gheru bead necklace, and this is something, you know, we picked up on a beach in Chennai. So yeah, and the next is some of my western wear jewelry, you know, which western wear jewelry. This is a choker which was gifted to me, again a very close to the heart gift to me. This is again, you know, a neck piece. This is also a choker with stone work on it. And yeah, so these are western wear jewelry. So we are done with this box. So you can also see that I paid like $565 for this box at one point in time. So this is another box which was kept up there. So this is a very, very beautiful drawer filled with some of my favorite stuff. This is a very beautiful neck piece, actually a set which is oxidized silver. This is all from my store, and this is something I picked up in Hyderabad in Shilparama again. So I stored it with cotton because all this is mirror work. Like you can see, it's got stone and mirror work, so it's a little, you know, not very strong, or it might just shatter. So I'm a little worried about that. So I've stored it in cotton. So this again is a gift which was given to me some time back. It's a long necklace, and again this has some stone and all in it. So I've stored it in a muslin cloth like that. And then this is a silver temple necklace. So this is something I bought recently. Again, like you see, I stored silver and all in plastic because if you store it in cloth, silver tends to get dark very fast. So this is the earring for that. So it's a very pretty necklace. And then this is again, you know, one of my silver anklets which my grandmother gave me. Like, it's hers, and then I took it from her. She never gave it to me. And again, it's all stored in cotton because this has got stone in it. So I'm a little worried as to it breaking or falling off. This has like a set of my nose pins, some of my nose pins that are there. So this is a, you know, Trishul nose pin, and this is, you know, a nice mango shaped nose pin. This is another pretty silver nose pin that I have, which, you know, I like very much. So yeah, that's it. So that makes my nose pin drawer. It's bought from Hyderabad. It's a chandbali with original pearls. It's one of my first earrings. And again, these are stone, and this is silver, so it's stored in plastic. This is again a chandbali, and this is a Navaratna jhumka, again in silver. So yeah, Moving on to two of the most interesting drawers, you know, this is like a big collection of stuff. So to go one by one, these are all the jewelry which is silver and what I wear for dance. So all these are my dance jewelry and its place. For example, I have like my rakodi, which you know we keep on the hair, and this is also hair accessories. So it's all placed like that in a very safe way. This is a gheru bead thing which I made for my hand. So yeah, so this is again my ear stud. It's all stored in plastic. All these are plastic bags. So this bag is a very useful one. I picked it up from a stationery store. So all these are silver jewelry. In case you want to see all this, I'll be more than happy to show it to you in another video, because if we go into exploring these, this video is not going to end. So this is a box which I have, you know, with all the threads and pins, and again this is a pin. I use quite a bit of pins every week for class. So this is again some of my earrings, and this is one of my necklaces that I use for dance. So yes, and yeah, this is again, you know, maybe I took this for a travel. This is also some oxidized silver jewelry. So yeah, so this basically contains of all my jewelry which I use for my dance. And this is another jewelry bag which I have, you know, with one or two earrings in it. I usually took it for a travel and forgot to remove the rest. I always keep some empty bags like this, because it's very helpful to quickly take and then, you know, put all your stuff and run. So this is another jhumka which I have kept, which is all related to my dance. This is another set which is also related to my dance. So yeah, in case you need to travel, you will have something handy. And this is again a silver set which was gifted to me by my grandma. So there you go. So this basically is the dance related stuff. And here I have like a blotting paper which is from Singapore. You know, this was very helpful, especially when we have dance shows. We are done with this drawer, so next up I'm moving into the second drawer, which is filled with my bangles and stuff. So these are some kadas bangles. These two I picked in Fab India, which are really beautiful ones. And these two were gifted to me again. And these are some lark bangles which I got them from Shilpa Ramam in Hyderabad. And these are some of my bangles which I wore for my wedding. So once that is done, I have another set of bangles. Again, these are what I wore during my wedding. I hardly use these, but you know, it's so pretty. I really don't want to give them away to anyone. I'm surely going to use it again somewhere down the lane. So here I have all my ghungroos and all that stuff over here. I have like four sets. So this white bag contains all my hair accessories which I've just thrown in, like the flowers and, you know, the kunchalam. So all this is used for Bharatnatyam. So basically it's my Bharatnatyam and my hair extensions which I've just folded and thrown in there. So that's some miscellaneous stuff. And this is again a bag which I use, you know, just in case I want to carry something. And yeah, all these are empty bags which I would just throw in stuff into and, you know, take during travels. So we come to the end of this drawer as well. So we are done with this whole unit. Hi, that's me. We have absolutely no light in this place, so I had to put up a soft box. So we are done with this. Now we'll move on to my other part, which is a bangle set. So I'm just gonna shift the light to this side so that you all can see what all I have on it. In this bangle stand, I have like, you know, some bangles. These are from Kolkata, again gifted. These are some silver bangles that I have, and these are again from Kolkata. These are some glass bangles, and this, I don't know the name, but they are so pretty. I love these bangles. And you know, this, out of laziness, some necklace that I was just thrown onto this. And on the other side, I have some, you know, wooden bangles over here. Again, wooden bangles. These are some metal kadas that I have, and again, these are kadas. some stuff which, you know, I just randomly take and wear. So this is kept outside, just it's displayed and kept outside so that I'm reminded to use these bangles, considering I have so many. So yes, that's about it.
So yes, my dear friends, we come to the end of today's video. I've tried to explain all that I could in this video as to how I have organized my space and how I've tried to fit in as much jewelry as possible into a small space. So hope this video was helpful, and if you all use any of my ideas, I'll be very, very happy to see how you have adapted it into your home. Don't forget to tag me. My Instagram page will be linked down below in the description box. And any comments, any suggestions or any improvements, I'll be very, very open to seeing all of it. So please post it down below in the comment box. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon so that you're notified whenever I post a video. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I'll see you all in another video. Bye-bye.